Good morning, dear parents. On behalf of Ananiketan School, myself Sunita Patel welcomes you all for the virtual orientation program for the new academic session of 2021-22. Today, we have with us our Honorable Principal, Ms. Vaishali Parikh, to throw some light on our child-centric philosophy and how we provide a creative and challenging education environment. While life is slowly limping back to normal, for most segments, the trauma still continues for students since they missed their schools. Especially for education sector, the shade of uncertainty shows no sign of shortening. Ma'am, we would like to know your views on impact of COVID-19 on education.
Namaskar, good morning parents. As Sunita ma'am rightly said, the impact of COVID-19 year back when we started a last year's session, there were so many challenges, but after 1 year, challenges are not there, but we are missing our student. We thought in between, yes, schools started reopening, students started coming in, and again this wave, second wave of pandemic has started, and again coming back to the same normal zone of online teaching. It is really getting into that mode. There are some blessings of technology which we use throughout the year and we are going to use in future as well. But the physical presence of the students definitely is missing in the school. In terms of education, we tried our level best to give a learning environment through online, giving education right from co-curricular activities, and academics has to be covered, the learning targets has to be achieved through this online activities. And I proudly said that the team ANBC has achieved it throughout 2020 and 21. And I'm hoping and all the best that 21-22 also we will rock it. It's virtually or physically, it's 50-50%. We never know what is there in future, but right now I'm quite confident enough that yes, academics will be get covered and as well as extracurricular activities to all my students will be getting over.
Yes, ma'am. I truly agree with your point. We have achieved and we are surely going to achieve it. Now, the thing is, what started as a unique fun experience of no classes and exams because of COVID-induced crisis is now making the students edgy and frustrated. So I just wanted to know that it has been a year with virtual teaching learning process and still the scenario goes on. Ma'am, what would you like to say for this new session to the teachers as well as students?
As right now I said that online teaching and virtual learning throughout the year, what I see major impact is happened to psychology of a student. Rather than just getting their assessments done and achieving learning targets, the impact of getting into throughout the year at home and maximum thing is that spending more time on screen, their psychology is completely changed to see the life, they are missing their physical world. And I'm quite sure that parents must be realizing that yes, it's a high time and how my school teachers are going to help us in this kind of situation. So first for student, upcoming year, we will try to focus on both the things. As I said earlier, academics is a prime motto, that is definitely we are going to achieve it. But we want to be a mentor of each and every child actually, because somewhere in this situation, as parents are also in their own world, is the uncertainty is for adults as well. So they are coping with their own challenges. So somewhere these young ones are got subsidized or they are not getting their own attention. They have their own feelings. They want to share everything with their friends. And virtually they are trying to connect with it, but somehow they need someone who is able to understand them, who is there, I can say they need empathetic ears, somebody is there to listen my problem, mm-hmm. and I can solve my problem by my own self, and I want teacher should take this ahead as a mentor, not as a coach or not as a teacher, not as an educator or class teacher or subject teacher, but be a mentor for each and every child for upcoming days to listen their own issues and giving that confidence to a child ki beta, don't worry, things are there, but we will overcome out of it. Let's hope for the best. I'm there for you. This kind of attitude for the teachers and my students should get into that comfort zone ki nobody is there, my teacher is there.
Surely the teachers will be there. And truly said, an emotional connection needs to be there between a teacher and a student. The child should be feeling that, yes, there is somebody, that warmth, that affection. For surely, the teachers will surely do it. Now, it is always said, with self-discipline, everything is possible. It is the bridge between goal and accomplishment. Ma'am, how discipline and rules and regulations are important for a student's life? Especially when the virtual class is conducted, right? For example, wearing a school uniform, right? Sitting on a proper table and a chair, like a study table, and doing regular homework and assignment and submitting on time. So,
yeah, that is the most important aspects you have asked me. Discipline for a student's life or a individual, basic human. Individual should have their own self-discipline is very important in this. In students' life, it is 110% more important. But as you said, this throughout the year, the self-discipline is the biggest issue from the parent side also, as well as teacher side also. Throughout the year, we have witnessed so many issues by the parent side and teacher side. So what I strongly believe in that. Slowly and steadily, we need to give this message to the student that this is life, and life has a very much importance how you live your own life. It's not for a school, it's not for the parent, but their own self, how it is important, how to be healthy and perfect life to live. Because if we tell the student that yes, get up at 6 o'clock and get ready for your school, they will say, ki, okay, fine, quickly, 7:45, I will do my brush and I will be in front of my screen to welcome my teacher. So it doesn't make any difference for us, their perspective at their own age, actually. Mm-hmm. If we will make them understand why it is important to wake up early, not for a school, not for a parent, but their own development. Because unless and until that importance is not given to that child, the aspects of life, yes, your body and mind should be healthy. For that purpose, you need to get up early, exercise in the morning, then get ready for your school. So whether it is a virtual school or a physical school, it doesn't make any difference. You have to be in that perfect zone for to grow your mind and body in a balanced way. Once that importance is given, and yes, absolutely, parents' role will be biggest role in this. Unless and until parents also needs to be in getting into self-discipline, yeah. Because I heard during PTM that parents were, ma'am, now throughout the whole year, we are also into that comfort zone. Yes, that when it is a physical school, we used to get up early because the child needs to go to school, I need to make a tiffin box for the child and so on. Mm. But they are also in that comfort zone. The child is at home, so I can take my own liberty and I can wake up at 7:30. So it is for both. It is for parent as well as child. If I am getting up early, I am doing my own exercise, I have my own early morning routine. Definitely child is going to observe you, and if he or she knows that yes, my parents are doing it, they have their own balanced life, and that is the most important, that they are your own parents are role model for them, and giving lectures will not impact, but observation is going to give them a best results. So parents, I wish and I hope that both the ways, by the student side also and the parent side also, discipline is very important in this case. Now you ask one more thing, that is school uniform for attending virtual school or when they will come to physical school. Throughout the 1 year, we didn't emphasize or we didn't force to the parents to buy a new uniform. But as a school principal or as a teacher, or we expect our student should be in a formal way to sit in front of a screen to attend this classroom. Whether child is not having school uniform and due to these all challenges parents are not able to purchase the uniform, that's absolutely fine. We are not making it mandatory, but I would like to say, make sure your child is wearing formal clothes. A formal attire should be there when he or she is attending the classroom in front of screen. Now third thing is, whether the child is sitting on the sofa, child is sitting on the bed, a strict no to sit on sofa and sit on the bed to attend the classes. Children can use their, if they have a study desk at home, they should completely use their study desk. Back should be straight. They should have that comfortable chair where their leg should not be hanging. The leg should be on the ground. The table height should be as per their appropriate body balance, so that the learning will be happen in a very different way. If they are sitting on a sofa or they are sitting on a bed, that comfort zone, or they are getting into very lethargic way they are attending the classes, learning is not going to happen that way. So big no for attending classes on bed and sofa. Also, I would like to suggest to the parents, now almost a year children are attending the classes on the tablets, on the some of the students must be attending the classes on the mobile, or some of them attending on the laptop. Now nowadays there are a lot of gadgets are coming in, and it's not that once they will be starting their physical school that this technology is not going to get away from them. So it is for sure that will be with them for a long term and long life, that is there. So I would suggest to have a bigger screen gadget for the students. That is the it is one time investment, but it is going to give a really comfortable eyesight for their eyesight. We should use a big screen gadgets for the students.
Truly said, at present the parents are the role model for the children.
Absolutely.
Whatever they will do, the children are going to observe. So parents needs to wake up. Okay, now it's high time. They need to provide all the facilities which are required, and it's a digital era, so things are not going to, technology is not going to close up tomorrow. It's going to continue.
One more thing, as you said, ma'am, everybody is in comfort zone, and we all are aware that 40 days needs to be given to change the habits. Okay, the habits for adults, the habits for the young ones. The thing is that we need to really check our vision. This generation is going to, how this generation is going to check their life in coming years. Every parent wants their child should be in a best way. He should or she should grow in a very best, comfortable manner. They are working so hard to give that comfort zone for them. But how much comfort zone should be given, that is also very important.
Surely, ma'am. Now, most of the parents, they complain, as we said, the screen time has increased. So that the whole day the students are on mobile, laptop, screen time has increased, which is affecting their health. So, ma'am, can you give an idea about the teaching methodology which we are going to follow for the next coming year?
As you said, the screen time has increased. It has increased triple or more than 300% actually, because earlier we used to give instruction not to hand over the mobiles to the students, and we are only given them these tools in their hands.
Scenarios opposite.
Absolutely. So I would like to suggest and say that first and most important thing, the timetable will be as such that every period, after every period, there will be 10 minutes break for a student. So during that break time, parents, I know for working parents it will be difficult, but those the adults who are taking care of the students, they should make sure that these 10 minutes the child should shut down, or the child should get up from the desk, have a glass of water, take a round of a whole house and come back to the own study area. That is one thing. So in a day, academics, 4 lectures will be there. The timetable will be given to the parents in the Microsoft team, as earlier we used to conduct the classes, same way we are going to conduct it. But we will make sure that some activities will be physical activities, which we already try and given our best throughout the year last year. Once they will be physically here, definitely the scene will be different, where they will be having their own physical activities on the ground. How to reduce this screen time is the biggest question for everyone nowadays. Not only students, but adults also, because working from home, so almost 8 hours they are spending their time on a screen or social media. The screen time is increased. Earlier, I had read one article which was given this thing. Every hospital will be having one cell nowadays in future where detoxification of a screen, the center name will be that, and I think it will be very soon everywhere. And in schools also, we will also have that kind of cell coming days. How to detoxify is this digitalization is a big question mark. But here I would like to give some tips. The timetable or the whole schedule of the students has to be given in a proper way. Okay, this is your school hours, this is your rest hour, this is your play time, this is your home assignment time. And one eye has to be there by the parents, what he or she is doing in the mobile, whether he or she is attending the class, or the screen is there and some games are played or whatever. The checkpoints has to be there for the students, whether it is a K-1 standard student or it is 9th standard student.
Or it is a higher grade
student.
Yeah. But yes, specifically the parents also, the mothers or the father should not be with mobile.
Absolutely.
That's the main thing, right?
They are talking to the child and they themselves are fiddling the mobile. That's not going to work.
Yes, as I previously said, they are observing. If I am telling this my daughter that don't use mobile and I am completely on mobile, she has completely right to give me the answer that you are on the mobile all the time, why not me? It's not giving answer back to a parent, then our motherhood and the ego gets hurt. Oh my God, my child is giving back answers to me. No, it's not back answer or it's not rudeness to give back answer. What he or she is observing, she is trying to follow that. If I'm not using, I have my own limitations for my screen time. See, I use this time to use mobile. So I can have a right to tell her or him that yes, this is the rule of my house and everybody will follow that. That way we can deal with it.
So in short, to decrease the screen time, the parents need to make a timetable, a schedule.
Yes,
coming to the activity part, ma'am, what you said, the co-curricular activities are essential part of school life. When the children are physically coming, yes, of course, they had sports and they have art, dance and everything, which helps in enhancing learning process of the students. Ma'am, kindly give us an idea about what type of extracurricular activities can be conducted virtually.
Yes, throughout the last year, our own parents, they have already witnessed that all the celebrations throughout the year, we did virtual celebrations. We will have art and craft sessions through online classes. We will have sports classes as well, online sessions, plus physically when they will be there. So during these kind of activities, we will give the students that space of their own creativity. What I had witnessed through this the whole year is that it was kind of burden for a parent when it comes to an activity given to the child to do it at home. So parents, it's my request to you, all of you, that whatever, however the child is going to do the presentation. It might be a for a garba presentation, or it might be a given assignment, a craft assignment, or drawing assignment. Whatever the extracurricular activities is given to the child, let her or him do it by himself. We will be more happy if it is not perfectly done by the child. If it is a shabby work or it is not present, we as a educators, we come to know the work is done by the parent or the work is done by the student. We know the how students do their work in front of our classrooms. So when it comes to very perfect model or when it comes to a perfect presentation, we come to know, yes, it's 100% dedication by the parent. We know all our mothers and fathers are very creative and they have their skills. But here we want to judge the skills of our own student. We want to give the space to our own students to show their own creativity, to show their own skills. We want to develop their skills. So here, whatever the task will be given in 2021-22 as a extracurricular activity, we would like to see our own students' creativity.
Yes, we at Anandiketan encourage skill-based learning.
Absolutely.
And parents can be a part of it, but not the whole.
Yeah.
Okay. Ma'am, I am sure that parents might be waiting for one thing, that is evaluation. Evaluation is concerned with assessing the effectiveness of teaching learning process. So I am sure the parents would like to know the assessment policy.
The CBSE has given the clear guidelines about the assessments, which is very clear that periodic tests will be taken, then 6 months term exam and then final exam. But somewhere evaluation or assessment exams, these are the things where parents really get worried about it. Oh my God, exams are there. Child needs to appear for 20 marks test. Child needs to appear for 80 marks test. So as our government is also bringing new education policy, somewhere within a year or 2 years, this assessment policy is going to really not going to work as such. As you rightly said that we believe in skill-based learning actually. So this year also our main focus will be assessment of their own skills. During this whole online learning, what I observed is that just mugging up and giving answers or just filling up the answer sheets giving to the teachers and then evaluation on that basis is not going to help us for future. Yes, the getting over with the year, academic year, definitely that kind of the whole process has been done. But the evaluation of skills is very important. Their reading skills, their writing skills, these are very important aspects. And we will have new strategies coming year. We'll try to give assignments will be given to them. Might be projects will be given to them. And as I said, parents definitely, they will require the help of parent when parent role is to give the opportunity, give the environment, give the facility. Yes, these gadgets or these things are with you. I am with you. Whenever you are in difficulty, I will definitely help. But don't depend on me to complete your project, to give the research. Let child do the research for the project. That's how they are going to develop their own skills. So these kind of evaluations we will be given, as we say it in terms of CBSE evaluation, subject enrichment activities will be more focused in coming year.
So we will surely focus on project-based learning, practical-based learning.
Whether it is a physical school or virtual school, these kind of learning will be there.
So it's a continuous evaluation throughout the year rather than only the subjective board papers. Okay.
So I really feel that parents really would like to know, okay, since last year it was all virtual online classes going on.
Now, maybe there are few children who have not attended properly and they are not focused. As I said, the pandemic has affected them emotionally and with,
yes, in all the ways, right?
So, there are few children who will be struggling as a, right? So, how we are going to fill up that learning gaps?
Yes, this is biggest issue and point here to discuss actually with the parents as well. What happened during last year 2020 March, when we started this pandemic, we were not prepared to handle the way the learning, virtual learning, will be happening. What kind of challenges as a teachers or a school we will face, or what kind of challenges parents will going to face in their own environment. Throughout the year, what I had observed, there is a two-way process actually, and it is not because of challenges or not because of pandemic. The school and parent has that kind of partnership. I always say it is a partnership. It is collaborative partnership. So we understand the time limitations, or their own issues with us, and even students, they have their own social emotional issues. When it comes to a learning part, the communication between the parent and the child has to be there. What time your classes are going to start, what your teacher has given any assignment, have you completed it, or if you have any problem to solve it, you can always talk to the teacher. These can, and every day spending at least minimum 10 minutes with your child without gadgets and just general discussion, and then coming to focus on the academics. Yes, have you completed your task or not, and why? These kind of question has to be asked by the parents. Now, learning gap by the school side. Yes, we have observed those kind of learning gaps. The instructions and the school has a policy, not because of virtual school learning, but every year we have this policy that we analyze the students as after assessments we come to know, okay, the child is here, and every teacher knows the learning gap of the students. Okay, these many student has these issues, whether it is writing or it is a concept clarity, or the throughout the year child faced these major issues. So during this break time, when the students were having a break, our teachers were working on those 5 or 6 students' analysis. Once the analysis is done, we give the task to the teachers that she needs to have an individual learning plan for those students. Once that planning is done, now almost parents are also aware about it. Their extra support classes are going to start, and we conduct this extra support class individually for those students to fill up those learning class. So one is having individual learning plan is very important here. As a school, we try to give to the student, and let's hope those gaps will be filled up and students are ready for next academic year.
Surely it will be done. Now, as you said, that kids learn best when they feel safe and secure. So the major concern is that it has increased our worries and concern about their physical health. Now, ma'am, what guideline would you like to give to our parents to develop a strong family relationship, especially for the working parents?
Yes. As I throughout our conversation, it was for the student by the parent. Yes. Kind of conversation was happening. So thing is that, there are certain guidelines I would like to give here for working parents, or it is household, mother is there, housewife is there, mother is there to take care of the student. The family bonding relationship is very important, not for a school, not for the academics, but overall social emotional health is very important nowadays. Because we are saying it's a social distancing, it should be a physical distancing. Social distancing, not a right word, I can say. We are in such a culture that social gathering or social emotional development is very important for us. And every human being requires that. So parents, make sure from your busy schedule, without TV or without any gadgets, at the time of breakfast or dinner, whenever you are getting, your family should have one meal together, all family members, whether it is grandfather, grandmother, all family members should be together for one meal of the day on the dining table, one restriction that there is no political discussion, there should not be corona discussion during this meal time. A happy environment should be there while having that meal. Ask the child how was the day, what he or she did, or share your own day with that. Okay, today I went and I faced these challenges. Or if you have any problem, ask for the solution. Nowadays, this generation is very smart. It's not that they required solutions from our side. They will give 100 solutions from their side and you will wonder that solutions really worked. So have humor while having dinner or have play time. As I said, discipline, self-discipline when you are having your physical exercise, might be yoga or might be a walk along with your child. During this walk, just show the nature. Yes, these trees, birds, have general discussion, have humor. Unless and until that bond is not formed with your child, this, however the learning academics targets or co-curricular activities or scale-based projects are not going to work at all. Once you form that bond or connect with your child freely, your child should speak to you without fear. And you, how you are going to form this bond? Once you start communication from your own side, the communication has to be from both the sides. If you are expecting that my child, I should be very friendly with my child. My child should share everything with me. Oh, nowadays this talk is very common in parenting tips that you should be very friendly with your child. Yes, absolutely. But the thing is that this friendly friendship starts with both the sides, not one side. Your child should be that comfortable to speak with you. He or she needs to understand my mother is friend for me. My father is friend for me. But that friendship will start, that friendship hand from first your side. So how that friendship bond is going to happen? Share your own childhood memories. Share your own issues during this age, what you used to do. So that child understand, okay, my father or mother is not big Hitler in the family, but she is a kind of person who has gone through all these changes in their life. They used to have their friends, they used to have these challenges. So once you start sharing those stories, they get comfortable speak up. So once that bond formed, it should be continuously. The consistency should be there. It's not that, okay, principal ma'am given the tips, from today I will start, or one day or 4 days and the consistency breakdown, the friendship is not going to happen in that way. It has to be consistency. The age group of child of 3 year or 18 year or 21 year, it has to be continuous bond. So challenges will be reduced and minimized. So these are the things which I think
it's a continuous process.
Continuous
communication
process.
Communication is the solution of everything.
And there is no Bible or there is no Gita of parenting. Every individual parent has their own individual experiences. On the basis of their own experiences, they can build up their own parenting thing.
And the situations are unpredictable. You never know what is the next situation. So there is no, as you rightly say, there is no Bible, no Gita where you will get a solution of it.
Yeah.
Ma'am, I just want to know that as we are talking about communication, how frequently teachers communicate with the parents?
Yes, you brought this point here. Teachers definitely connect with the students as they are conducting the classes. But there are certain things which teacher observe, or they face some challenges during this communication classroom. They try to connect with the parents. Frankly speaking, there are few parents, they are very supportive. They try to understand, my school teacher is calling up for my child and for his or her development. But I understand they are very busy with their own schedules. But the parents, one request is that school teacher is calling up for a student, make sure that you are attending their calls. Try to understand their communication, why he or she is calling. The major communication part is not completing the homework, not completing the assignments, And if teacher calls twice or thrice, parents also get into that mode. It's my headache. He or she is not doing. Why you are calling me up again and again? These kind of communication happens. But our concern is that to bring to your notice. See, the thing is that not to make you harassment or not to make you disturb. Teacher also has their own schedule. They have their own time limitations. During these busy schedule, she is trying to give you a message that it's high time to give attention to your child. That's
so, like, the parents also need to look into the matter. Right? And they need to communicate with the teachers also. It's not only, as you said, the teacher's part. It's the parents' part also. The parents are
absolutely
needs to be concerned about
the child's academic or child's education.
And we are most welcome. We always see that. I always believe in that. I already said that communication should be from both the sides. Most, if you have facing any issues regarding your child's virtual learning or any academics issues, books issues, uniform, transport, any XYZ things, parents kindly write mail to the admin or me or the coordinator. You can call up us. The one request is that during this pandemic and this, parents have got the numbers of the teachers. Parents, as I said, they have their own personal life also. It's not 24/7 call center line. Yeah. Make sure when you are calling a teacher, you just make sure that the working hours of the school, during that time, if you call them, that's the best thing to call and communicate.
Now, if we talk about coming to the teacher's point of view, now in this era of technology, the digital revolution has transformed almost everything from our work at our organization to our daily routines. Ma'am, do you think children would require a school educator in this present scenario? Because everything is on Google.
That's there. It's a big question and it's a really valid question
for teachers also.
It's a concern for teachers, it's a concern for a parent as well, because nowadays a lot of companies are there and they are offering gadgets. Yes, virtual teacher is there to teach your child. Homeschooling is coming up nowadays, whether teacher is required or not. Sunita ma'am, one thing is very important here is that whatever sudden in challenges or whatever sudden in future is lying in for us, the main fact nobody can change it is that nobody can replace the educator from students' life. Yes, but educators will not accept the technology. Definitely technology is going to replace them. The thing is that educators also has to adapt it. Okay, this is change has to be there. I need to change my teaching methods. I need to work on my planning and to giving my child academics. For parents' perspective, the human touch is very important. Might be I will give a software, might be I will give you Google to my child to have a research to learn. But yes, as I said in the first thing is that a human touch, a human connect, a warmth, the connection of a teacher student relationship is very important, that no robot or no software is going to give them. That's there.
Surely, like the teachers at present, because the children, they are in this digitalized era, the children are more smarter, they are more practical. So for surely the teacher also needs to be upgraded.
Our main aim is to make them human and make them remain human. That's it.
So on a whole, Anandiketan creates a place where all individuals can develop their individuality in a socially accepted manner.
Thank you, ma'am. It was really parents will really know about the whole system and how we go ahead.
I hope we have cleared all their doubts. If parents, if you have any queries, doubts, as I already mentioned, you can contact to admin office. You can send us a mail and stay healthy, stay safe. Namaskar.
On a whole, Anandiketan creates a place where all individuals can develop their individuality in a socially accepted manner.